failed us because we've done so that he could have spoken to us here. But I learned that he cannot do that either. But wait a minute. I am here. I'll tell you about the torments. I'll tell you about the sleepless nights. I'll tell you about the worries and all that we endured. 100 more days than is legally provided for registration of political parties. It took us 100 more days before the NGC could get its certificate. But we are not worried.
No.
Because God is on our side. And we got our certificate just in time when they had messed themselves up in their conventions. So that everybody is running to us now. And here we are today. But I'm here to launch the NGC. So let's talk about the party. This is a party of progressives, Kande has told you. It's a party of like minds, of citizens who believe that if we work together, we can make the change that we all hope for. And we can make our country a place to be proud of. We believe that. This is a party that breaks these obsolete practices and traditions of tired and old parties. This is a party of inclusiveness, open to all citizens, irrespective of region, tribe, or even previous party affiliation. And they're coming to us because this is a party that commands respect, and it commands the confidence of the people. This is a party that commands respect of our regional neighbors. I am in a position to tell you that this is a party that commands respect of the international community as well. But I'd like to say that we want to build a strong party, a party that will survive and sustain its life after the elections and beyond. Our emphasis is on the team and team building, and not only on individual personality. We work together and respect our different views. We trust our presidential candidate, and he too trusts us. We are a team, not a dictatorship like other parties, political parties, which in the 21st century are still producing chairmen for life. Ours is a party of the future. The NDC is a party of the future. And this is a party that is youth-oriented. The young people must show the way. Right now, as I'm speaking to you, all over the country, the young people are leading this campaign in their neighborhoods. I was in Putlaka not very long ago, and I spoke to a lot of young people in Putlaka. They don't care about the old affiliations and the old loyalties. They don't give a damn about that. They just think about the future, about their country, and they want to run. And it's amazing, the spirit that you see in these young people. They are ready to go through the fire for NDC and for their country. And we are with them. This is the party you're going to like. The NDC is a party of the diaspora. Woo! The diaspora are co-drivers of our campaign. They are co-drivers of our campaign in the battle for State House. You guys are making an extraordinary contribution and participation in the coming elections. Yes, there is finance, and we're going to need a lot of money. But this election is different, and the role that you are playing is unprecedented. This, your new system and your new approach of a remote control campaign in the villages and towns, this thing is winning this game for us. It's winning this election for us. And we thank you very, very much for what you are doing for us. It is making things easy for us, because by the time we get there, and they say, "Now you begin just call me for my money, person." I say, if not puts this thing that I box in, yeah, something will happen. So I walked into my office one morning, and this is a true story. I walked into my office one morning, and there are these three women chatting with the people who were doing the registration with them. So I went to shake hands with them like I normally do.
DJ
Miller. I got to learn that they were selling these were traders at Dovecot Market. And they had come all the way to Tengbe Town in the morning to register for NGC. So I asked them, I said, how do I manage death now? Market for come is death. I said, you not know that? Again, somebody in America had worked the magic. And that's how we went there. But you know what? In the conversation we had, she said something to me. She said, the other people where I get, now inside the market, we don't sell, we don't go for a big college. See, we don't do. She said, but look at our house. With me for 3 years now. And not even that. You see, we said, we don't tire. You see, this Alasan and Alusan. Let them go to the house. Now, the other one, see, now Aki and Bobo, and the Bobo Sidona, Le Emmanuel, and so, since the convention in Bo and the launching of the party in Freetown, the NGC has probably become the fastest growing party in Africa. It's building momentum. Now that we have our flag bearer, inroads have been made into main towns and cities, such as Kotloko, Makini, Cambia, Kabala, Mboka, in the north. But we still need to hit big towns and cities in the southeast and the chiefdoms all over the provinces. Election management and campaign committees are all working currently. And the manifesto committee will soon be completing their work. The party structures are being established throughout the district and constituency executives. Almost all are in place now. Also, the diaspora executive structures are being set up. And also, the main party organs, such as National Women's Bureau, the Young Stalwarts Bureau, the Party Candidacy Committee, and the Party Disciplinary Committee all are being set up now. Even the Secretariat needs to be properly equipped. And it's all happening at the same time. So we are tremendously busy. We are very, very busy at the moment. And we also need help. However, the reasons we are doing all this together is because we agree that change must come now. Judging from my personal experience in Kotloko and my 91, and the youth and women that I saw, and the general show of disgust and disappointment with both of the traditional parties, even people who do not normally get involved in politics are now coming out in their numbers in the open to support the NGC, I know that change is coming. And as a party, we need to define that change, the change that we are all talking about. Kale don't talk to now, I'm sure. They don't talk to now about 10 building blocks. They don't talk about governance and the social sector. They don't talk about economic growth and competitiveness. You know, Kande is a big business, it's a big book. Now I'll tell you that. And before you ask a question, you know, they get what they call knowledge, they get what they call skills. And God give all man human talent. But you find for lay when somebody gets in talent, we respect them. We left my cup in that. Then we respect them. But in a salon, I don't see we lack for each of the best citizens. That is wrong. You go to a place like Ghana, when they call Kofi Annan, there's hardly any town where you don't get streets named after Kofi Annan.
Yes.
There's hardly any school or any town where you don't get a school name after Kofi Annan. There's hardly anything you can do in Ghana. You're not hearing about Kofi Annan because of the contribution we don't make, not just to Ghana, in spreading the name and the reputation of the country. Now we have Kande, who has gone so far to spread the name of Sierra Leone. There's hardly any street named after him in Sierra Leone. We should change all that. We have to respect the people who promote our country. We have to respect them. We have to give our honor where honor is due. Let us lift our leaders. Let us lift our idols. You know? And I wish the day would come. I wish the day would come when some of you, because of the contribution you're giving in your small village, somebody would lift something, a monument to your name, and say, that's it, the Ugonema after Baba Alaba. But all that should change, because we can say Salomon Gebadat, but when something happened, we can rise up to the occasion. We all know that also. Well, let this be the occasion of our lifetime. The 7th of March should be the day that Sierra Leone changed for the better. You know, the NGC is not just interested in the change of policies and programs. We are not just interested in the change of a president. It's very easy to just change a president. Eh? We've done it before. We are not just interested in the change of a party in power. That is what Al-Hussein and Al-Assad want to do. You know what they call this musical chairs? Okay? The one that is dancing, continues dancing, and then somebody drop. But the music is the same. So we're not just interested in change of party in power. We're not just interested in the change of persons close to the bar. We're not just interested in changing the colors. We are much more interested in changing the way our people perceive development. That basic services are really basic and that they are entitled to them.
They are right.
The NGOs in Sierra Leone, they interviewed people all over the country and they came out with what they call a citizen's manifesto. You know, if you study the politics of our recent times, we have been changing from one agenda to the other. How will they change agenda so people then they suffer? We don't come off from meeting prosperity. No, we come off from change. We go to prosperity. We go to austerity. I think we don't cross alaki. All kinds of agenda. But maybe it is telling us that nobody has a right to just put out an agenda. Listen to the people. Let the people speak for themselves. They know what they want. And in that citizens' manifesto, you would never believe that if you ask me What is the first thing that we need to handle? It is corruption. But do you know what they got from the citizens? Their number one priority? Water. Water. And that opened my eyes. Dropping my kid in school in the morning, in the early hours of the morning. When you see them, rubber. The small beginner. They can always early. They took them over and they forget and go up the hill. Then I understood why the first priority they had was water. These things that we take for granted, especially you out here, let us think of the people. Oh dear, on a try, no will change that country. The NGC is also interested in changing the way government works and for whom it works. Because if you go there now, it's a government now for a handful of people and then they work for it. No, so?
Yes.
What about the rest of the people? It's a man, their mind for going to read you. If you go talk to the nonsense, go no more the bank. When the election can go out there and go vote for we still. Then they feature the people and pass up the bargain. And they feature the people. But I know that on the 7th of March, they will teach them a lesson. We also have to change the way people perceive their leaders and the way they see themselves. We are all in politics, but we are supposed to be servants of the people. We are not supposed to be gods or demigods that people worship. We are not supposed to be worshiping our leaders.
Yes, they're human beings.
The people that we elect are supposed to be serving us. So, we have to change the way our people consider their leaders. We also need to work on the way people perceive themselves. Do you know that in Sierra Leone we have what we call foreigner worship? They worship foreigners. Look at just the ordinary guys there. You walk into an office, you talk Creole. In a different way they look you. But as somebody comes inside, they look different. They go not wrong go for Gosaba. It is saying something about ourselves, the way we perceive ourselves. We have to work on that. So that the people will get the dignity that they should have as Sierra Leoneans. We have to change the way we deal with ethnic and other differences. One of the people who led the prayers asked the Christians to stand when they were reading the Fatiha. We are very proud to say we are tolerant. We have religious tolerance. But as soon as you come to a child, and you have a few people using that to divide us, we are not going to build Sierra Leone if we continue to think that way. We have to change it. We are one. As a people, we are Sierra Leoneans. And don't forget that these differences we have is also the wealth that we have. It would be bad if we all had money. No, so? Enough for fine if we all are money. No, so? But if I were going to eliminate it, you're eating
Canada life,
they show you the richness
within our country, the diversity, going for harness, and all that for our culture. We should put them together in one place so that everybody will see that we have diversity in our culture. We don't even develop our culture anymore to see the beauty that we have in our culture. We don't do that. But our differences, our ethnic differences should not divide us. They should make us stronger. I'll finish in a minute. We have to change the way we deal with time. We have to change the way we deal with time. All these things that I'm saying means that real change requires a total change in mindset. And it implies the courage to see things and do things differently. It is not easy for our people who have been used to seeing and doing things in the same way for over 56 years to understand that a third serious party can actually take over. It is not easy for our people. For 56 years, they have been used to the same old thing, one after the other. And it is difficult for them to see that a new party can take over. This is why we all must come together and work. Now, let me cut this short. More and more people are coming to volunteer. But I can tell you that although we need to engage more functional staff than we have now, we need a lot of things to get there. Initially, a total budget was proposed in the region of $10 billion. I understand that APC are working on something close to $30 billion. But I'm not sure if that is correct, but this is what you hear in the grapevine. But then we have reviewed our budget. It has come down to seven. Some people have the opinion that we need $7 million or $5 million. We're just whispering. But we've started working. And all you're doing now is to support that project and raise funds for us. We need funding for the full establishment of the secretariat. We need funding to establish 11,200 polling station executives.
Sorry guys, my battery's
dying. You know, we have 11,200 polling stations.
Bye-bye.
We want five people, executives of NDC in each of those polling stations.